What's up, guys? Flippin' Steve back with another video, and today's video is going to be a little bit different. As I talked about on my live drive the other day, I'm going to incorporate a little bit of my everyday life in today. The wife's at work, so I'm going to go out with some friends, do some par three golfing. I haven't hit a golf ball on a course in over 15 years. I have been to the driving range, but haven't done much with it. I'm going to go out and have some fun, see what me and my friends get into besides that. And I'm also going to incorporate talking about cards. I'm going to do my series of three awesome cards that I've seen for sale on eBay that I would like to buy. However, they're just a little bit out of my price range, but going to show them to you guys because looking at awesome cards is always fun to do, regardless if they're yours or not. So we're going to get into looking at some cards and a little bit of my boring everyday life. See how you guys like something like this. If you don't like it, I won't keep doing it. If you do like it, you know, comment below and let me know how you feel, because really, what I want to do is just put out content that keeps you guys entertained and keeps you guys connected with me and the relationships that we've built, whether it's just through you guys watching my videos or meeting in person at shows, or whether we've done deals or trades, you know, whatever it may be, my live streams. Just want to keep that connection, that relationship going, regardless of what is happening in the hobby. So guys, really looking for some feedback below, and we're going to get into this video and just see where it lands. Head out and play a little golf today, some par three with my friends. I haven't golfed in years, at least 15 years. First, we're cooking up the egg whites, trying to eat healthy, trying to lose a little bit of weight. You know, I need to be around for my daughter, start taking care of myself a little bit better. So, got the sweet potatoes over here. Probably have a sweet potatoes with some of my egg whites and go out and see if I can still hit a golf ball. Breakfast almost done. We're gonna slap some cheese in that. Cooking with Flipping Steve, flipping eggs here. Put some eggs on top so that'll melt. Woohoo! Oh, doggy, want me to share my breakfast? Come here. There you go. All right, guys, so Flipping Steve here. Walking to meet my friends. They're going to pick me up to go golfing, so I don't have to drive, but I don't want to have to come down the street. I live on a one-way street, so just going to walk down the block. They're going to pick me up, and what we're going to do is I'm going to go ahead and get into these cards, sweet cards on eBay. The very first card that I want to talk about, and there's actually two of these listed on eBay, is a 2016 Immaculate Dual On Card Auto. I believe it's numbered out of 49. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Kobe Bryant. The reason I like this card and think that it's awesome is because, what else can you say? Two all-time Laker greats. I'm not a Lakers fan, but it is a big market. Two of the best Lakers, arguably the best Lakers to ever play. Some people may say Wilt. Some people may say Magic. You guys leave in comments below who you think are the best two Lakers to ever play. I would say Kareem and Kobe's right there, neck and neck with Magic. Kareem is definitely the number one, I would say. Probably number three basketball player overall. But that's not the debate here. Just an awesome card that I wanted to show you guys. One's listed at about 15K, and the other listed at 19, close to 20,000. Ridiculous price, in my opinion. Still a great card or best offer. But, you know, sometimes to get these cool cards, people want you to pay up for them. And that's why I like to show these cards, even though I'm not even going to be able to buy these. I just think they're really neat. Let me know what you guys think. Numbered out of 49, dual on-card auto. Kobe Bryant, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. It is hot out here. It's at least 95 degrees. And we're going to go out in the middle of a golf course with no shade, bald head. Hopefully I got some protection here. And see how I can do against my friends. Introduce you to a couple of those knuckleheads when the time comes. Some of it. Some of my friends. Paul. Richard. So, why do we call you Paul?
Because I'm a dick.
Because nobody wants to be a dick, right? Caleb in the house. We call this guy Cousin Jay right here. Because he's a Buffalo Bills fan.
Look, they got Bills beer over there. Bills,
well, why don't you get some of it?
Because it's not cold.
Who's the best football player in the NFL right now? YouTube wants to know.
Josh Allen.
Josh Allen, you gotta say it louder.
Josh Allen.
Oh, he doesn't say it with confidence, guys, yeah. So you know what that means. Roll up in here. Cool, my friends are already in the liquor store, and they think that my tripod with my phone
is a hatchet or a machete. Yeah, so go figure. Okay, so tell everybody the pills mafia, what's it got on it? People jumping through tables.
At the tables, the buffalo.
The buffalo.
Pancho Villa.
Pancho Villa. Who's Pancho Villa?
He was just like a super fan.
Super fan. I'm gonna go with the girly drink, guys. Get the game day punch. I can't drink all six of these, maybe two of them, because they're just sweet. I don't drink that much, so we're gonna go with this for now. See if it can stay cold. Probably get hot on the golf course. Hold on. We got Shaggy making his YouTube debut. Sun's out, guns out. He's got a. Hold on, Shaggy. You got a shout out to YouTube.
I don't think I do.
Of course, you can look at his face and know why he's called Shaggy. He's got to get some sunblock on there. Tyler, got anything to say before we go out here and tee off?
Yeah.
Who's winning today?
I am.
You are?
Yeah.
Tyler/Hermie. All right, we're back with Paul. Paul, did you manage to make it to the golf course sober?
Yeah.
Yeah?
One shot.
What time of day is it?
It's
sober. It's 1:30.
On my day off.
You made it past noon on your day off, and you're still sober.
Amazing.
Oh, my goodness. Well, we'll have to see what sober Paul looks like on the golf course. Everybody's headed out to the course. My only goal of the day, Paul, come here.
What's up?
My only goal of the day is to beat this guy right here.
Not going to happen.
If I lose to him, it's a complete failure. My only goal of the day is to beat him.
It's going to be failure.
I won't beat Drew. Drew's gonna be playing at the top. But my only goal is to beat this guy right here. Seriously, Shaggy, an Eagles towel? Let's see it. Should get a discount. This has to be on the clearance rack. All right, so while these guys are warming up behind me, we're gonna talk about card number two, which is a football card. And this is gonna be, the year is actually skipping my mind, but I believe it's a 2014. I will correct myself if I'm wrong. This is a booklet from Topps Supreme, which is not a brand that I really know much about. However, it is a dual auto game used patch of Tom Brady and Peyton Manning, which in my mind, at least growing up, these are probably the two best quarterbacks to ever play. I know a lot of people are going to say Joe Montana and Tom Brady, but for me, I'm a fan of Peyton Manning, so Tom Brady and Peyton Manning on the same card. This card is not only an auto, dual auto with game-used patches. The patches have multiple colors, and it's also numbered out of 15. Not only is it numbered out of 15, but it's number 12, which is Tom Brady's jersey number. It's impossible for the card to be Peyton Manning's jersey number because, of course, we know he was jersey number 18. So this is numbered out of 15, Tom Brady serial number, you know, jersey number 12, card number 12 out of 15, dual auto game use patch booklet. Just an amazing card, another awesome card that I really like. And you guys let me know what you think about this one. Is this a card that you would like to have in your collection? All right, guys, got not a good start as I double bogeyed. I got a 5 on the first hole, shanked my drive, had a good second shot, had to get a feel for the green. It's been a long time. Teed off on the second hole. Not too bad, so yeah, let's see.
Hey, Russell.
So there were some ladies on the last hole. They asked Shaggy to take his shirt off for this one.
That's perfect. It would be if he was straight.
Huh. Still sober, still alive?
Still sober, two over.
Two over my ass.
Oh, shit.
Two over double bogey.
Yeah. Well,
two over double bogey. Get out of here.
Where are you
at? Whatever. No, I ain't getting Cousin Jay. I'm getting Paul over here, man. This bench got a weight limit.
Yeah.
Just don't sit in the middle.
That's why I'm on the end.
How many breaks you take?
Yeah, we stopped at the clubhouse.
As many as possible.
Uh-oh.
That sucker got off.
It looked good off the thing. Cousin Jay, where did it land?
That sucker.
Oh,
got off.
Silence says enough.
All right,
so we're about to hit a baby 75 at number 14. And RT is matching up with the green that these guys are on behind us. So the group is all back together again. Paul, got a hat on now.
Birdie
my ass.
He got birdie ass.
Better be careful squatting down like they're going to rip your pants. All right, two putt for birdie. Let's go. You want to be on? You want to be on YouTube? Oh, man, you got to make this one to finish it off. All right, Drew for birdie here. Little short. For par, you got to make it. What are we betting on this? Drinks? Oh, man, I don't know why you didn't bet. Cousin Jay, he needs some help. Stop and take a break. It's beaming hot. Just to say that this video is brought to you by Alt. Yes, another lost tripod out here on the golf course. Tripod's gone. Handheld phone now, so maybe it'll turn up. We might do another 18. Do not know. Jay, your cousin Jay for YouTube. What are you getting to eat?
Asian Zing.
Asian Zing.
And cheesesteak.
Well, how was your golf game today? Why you think about that? Let's come over to Shaggy. Shaggy, how was your golf game today?
It was good.
Good? Better than normal?
About average.
You just followed my lead. You did pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, I was behind Shaggy most of the day. Here's Paul.
My game was on point.
Now, see, Paul played in the second group because he knew that those guys wouldn't tell the truth. They would fudge the scorecards for him. He would get the tee off three times on every hole. So, yeah, we did see you do that.
I had some bad holes, not gonna lie.
Oh, I had some meltdowns. I think everybody had a couple meltdowns, but.
But I had some good ones.
Did you figure out how you played yet today?
You know, I was looking like young Tiger out there, really striking them on the green. I was looking good. The putts were.
See, now YouTube knows you're lying.
But them tee shots were looking.
Is that how you want to be known to the people? Someone who doesn't tell the truth. Oh my goodness. So cousin Jay Caleb got some wings. I got some wings. But he got the blue cheese. I got the ranch. He says what? What do you say, Caleb? Blue cheese is the best?
How they're supposed to be eating.
That's how they're supposed to be eating, so he says. And he's a Buffalo fan. He says they're supposed to be eating with blue cheese. I say ranch. You guys comment below. Are you a blue cheese or a ranch person? All right, guys, long ass hot day of golf. Stopped and got some food. Coming back, gonna take a swim. Shaggy over there chilling. Maybe play some shuffleboard. But yeah, gonna go ahead, cool off. Look at the sunburn turning a little red. And then gonna come back and hit you guys with the last card of the three listed on eBay. Here, guys, we're gonna see if I can hit a 10. If I can hit a 10 on this, the card market is gonna stay the same that it is right now. And if I miss, it's gonna stay the same that it is right now. Let's go. Oh, we are not within the 10. We're on the line, pretty close, but nope. Cousin Jay, Paul, what took you scrubs so long to get here?
I had to go get my bathing suit, but when I put it on, it's amazing. Straight 90s.
Yeah, right. You're not even, like, ready to get in the pool or anything.
I'm going to be ready, and it's going to be banging.
All right.
You're going to have all the chicks on flipping Steve. Man, who is that guy when he takes his shirt off?
Yeah.
They like the dad bod.
You definitely got drunk in your time that it took you to get from.
I'm still sober. All my day off.
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys, finally back another day. The next morning, back to finally wrap up this video. If you guys have stuck through this video, man, I don't know how you've done it. Watching me, watching my friends, a bunch of goofballs, doing a bunch of boring stuff. But anyway, I'm back to wrap it up with the third card. And the third card is going to be another non-sports card. I always tend to have one of those in these series when I do them. So a lot of times they're not as attractive to you guys that like the big fancy sports cards. But I think this card is really cool. And one reason I picked this card personally is because it relates to my wife. And it's a card that I would like to have to share with my wife and to show to her, just like my old Walt Disney card. And the card in question, or the card that I'm talking about, is a 2017 Upper Deck Goodwin's Champions Stephen King autograph. Yes, yeah, Stephen King, the author, the writer. Richard Bachman is his other pen name. But again, everybody knows the name Stephen King. You either like his books, you like his movies, or you dislike his books or dislike his movies. But you have seen a Stephen King movie, I'm pretty sure, in your lifetime. Whether it's one of his horror classics or, you know, a cooler movie like The Green Mile or something like that. And again, a card that my wife would love, a card that I would love to add to my, not outside the box, but my alternative card collection, my non-sports. You guys know I love that stuff, and I would love to add this Stephen King. I believe it's around the $3,000 mark. I need the price to come down on that. And again, it's not a card where you get a market price, so I can't wait for the price to come down. I either got to give the seller what they want or try to make a deal in order to get that. But just another cool card. You guys let me know what you think about that. Thanks for sticking through this video. I know it was probably brutal, but if you did and you got to the end, then you're going to be able to answer some questions on my next live stream, because I'm going to be asking questions from this video for the national giveaway. No, I didn't forget, and I know I haven't mentioned it throughout this entire video, but yes, the national giveaway is still going on. So make sure you watch this video once, twice, thrice, however many times it takes you to get some of the information in your head, because I'm going to be asking questions on my next live stream. Again, guys, thanks for joining me. And if you enjoyed this content, comment below. And I will do a video like this every now and then where I incorporate my friends or my family and, just continue to build, relationships out there, and connect with you guys. And so you guys let me know what you think. All right. I'll see you guys next time around. Good luck in your investing, your collecting, your flipping, whatever it is that you do in the hobby that brings you enjoyment. Good luck with it and have fun. I'll see you guys later.